Lloyd Roll, aka Mega Blitz. Today's video, we're going to be talking about Gym Leader Challenge. Just this past week, I got a chance to play in my first ever Gym Leader Challenge tournament. And I really wanted to take the time to just kind of talk about my thoughts and opinions of the format Gym Leader Challenge, my just overall experience in playing in the format, the decklist that I had played, my record with that decklist, and of course, whether or not I earned a badge with that deck. So now let's jump right in to that decklist. Already here at that decklist, I did end up playing grass to my first Gym Leader Challenge tournament, and it was really tons of fun. Being able to get that Torterra into play and then having that Evo press get to numbers like 200 and 250 damage felt really incredible. Evo press saying for two energies, 50 times. This attack does 50 damage for each of your evolution Pokemon in play. So we're kind of playing a more of like a stage two, stage one type deck. I'm trying to get into the Torterra. I'm trying to establish that item lock with that Vileplume, making it so each player cannot play items. And of course, having that Rillaboom set up as well for that Voltage Beat ability, being able to search your deck for two grass energies and attach them to your Pokemon is really great for acceleration. We have an Amoongus in there as well for kind of like a backup attack or some status condition type stuff. The Shining Genesect is a basic Pokemon. However, it really is a great attacker, especially in a pinch. Being able to move some of your grass energies to that Shining Genesect, and as you move those energies, the damage kind of scales more so, was really powerful. That Krikatoon being able to give plus 40 HP to all of my grass type Pokemon was really helpful, especially in the one matchup where my Torterra was at 230 HP thanks to that Krikatoon and was able to tank a hit of 200 damage. And then of course we have that Cheramon there with that Spring Bloom ability as well, as often used like during your turn. You may attach an grass energy to one of your Pokemon that don't have a rule box. So really just trying to get that Torterra set up, establish item lock, get the Voltage Beat rolling, and just start hitting really big damage with that Torterra. And of course, for the record in just some of my matchups that I got to play in. So round one, I did end up playing against Water, kind of like a Kingdra type strategy, being able to just kind of keep refilling the hand and try to just really get quick damage in and out as fast as they could. Did end up taking the win on that. It was kind of a clean sweep. I was able to get, you know, Turtwig, Rare Candy, and Torterra. I was able to get into the Gloom and Vileplume very quickly. I got Voltage Beat set up really fast as well. It was really just able to establish all the pieces that I needed in the entire just game. And then the second round, I ended up playing against Dark. It kind of felt like Turbo Dark almost, playing like the Hoopa if it retreats and then comes back. Basically, it does more damage and stuff, which was very helpful for them. Having the Sableye, be able to like look at the top card, discard it and stuff. I was able to pick up the win there as well. Very close game, but once I had item lock established, they couldn't really do anything. Dark Patch was out of the question. They couldn't play Earth and Vessel. They couldn't Super Rod. They couldn't really do anything. So getting that item lock was very important in that matchup. And then for the third and final round, I played against Psychic Spread. Now, both my opponent and I did brick. I just ended up bricking a little less than my opponent. I was able to go natural attach energy for turn three times to my Shining Genesect and was able to really establish a nice lead with like three prize cards. We had like a 3-6 split. So I was able to establish a really nice lead because of that. So I did end up going 3-0 to earn my grass badge at my first ever Gym Leader Challenge tournament. Now for the rest of the video, we're just going to kind of talk about my thoughts and opinions of the format itself and just kind of my emotions while playing in the tournament. So let's jump right into it. Alrighty, so I really just want to take a moment to talk about all these different topics and emotions that I was feeling when playing in this Gym Leader Challenge tournament. And one of the really big ones that I just kept feeling the entire time when playing was the feeling of not really knowing what was going to happen. There's so many different cards you can play with, and there's so many different cards that we have access to in this format that it's really hard to know what your opponent's going to be playing and what they're going to be cooking up, as opposed to the standard format where when I see a Gardevoir deck, I kind of know I'm going to, okay, I'm probably going to see a Drifloon, I'm probably going to see, you know, Screamtail and Bravery Charm, and I'm going to be seeing Psychic Embraces and all that stuff. But with Gym Leader Challenge not having any rule box Pokemon, a small ban list, and so many different cards that we have access to, the possibilities are endless, really. You can play an entirely different grass type deck than I played and do just as good, if not even better, with that deck. And I think that's awesome. I think that's a sign of a healthy format, really being able to just have so many cards at your disposal, being able to cook up all different kinds of strategies, not only within the different types, but within the same types, and I think that's awesome. So really being able to just have all these different cards that are accessed seems like a very healthy format, because there's going to be so many different lines of play and so many different cards that we could be using. And that also kind of ties into something else. So many cards that my opponents played, I had no idea what they did. I think just in that tournament alone, I asked, can I read what that does? More than I did the entire time I went to the Indianapolis Regionals. And I played for like 6 hours in that tournament. And not one time did I really have to be like, oh man, what does that card do? But in Gym Leader Challenge, I had to ask that every time against my opponent multiple times. And I think that's incredible, especially for someone who's only been playing the game for just a short time, being only like 2-ish years. All these cards I would have never gotten to play with, things like Floatstone and Field Blower. I did get to play with Cynthia and Caitlyn just a little bit, but Bridget, Gladion, even Guzma is a card I never really got to play with. And I think it's awesome that I got to play with all these cards. That Vileplume with the item lock was tons of fun to be able to play with. But there's also so many different lines that you can make because of all these different unique strategies that can be cooked up in Gym Leader Challenge that opens up for so many awesome lines of play. And the format feels a lot slower paced as opposed to Standard, where you can get that turn one attack off pretty consistently. But in Gym Leader Challenge, there was a couple times where I didn't end up attacking till like my third turn or even my second turn. You know, sometimes if you're going second, that first turn you get, you can just take an entire KO and take, well, at least one or two prize cards in Standard. But in Gym Leader Challenge, I never really got a chance to do that. My round one, my opponent and I didn't take a single prize card until I think like 15 minutes into the entire round. And I was like, that's incredible. Also, being able to take on the role of a gym leader, I think is something that is really interesting. You're kind of dedicated to that one type, so you don't really have to worry about things like Manaphy unless they're playing a water deck. If I'm playing a fire deck, Manaphy's not going to be in my deck. So if I'm playing against my opponent and I'm like, okay, they're on a grass deck, I don't have to worry about Manaphy. I might have to worry about Rabska, but not Manaphy. And I think that's really interesting because the pool is so big, but also yet so limited, because you're capped to just that one type that you can play in your deck. And I think also something that I thought was really fun was you really have to be able to determine what the big threats are in the decks, because there can also be so many different threats going on in that person's deck because you only play one copy. So for the grass deck that I was playing, Voltage Beat is my accelerator. Helps me set up all my Pokemon, gets energies out. Vileplume is just disruption. Item lock, I don't really ever try to attack with it unless I have to. But the Shining Genesect and the Amoongus and the Torterra are the main attackers of the deck. Sure, I can attack with the Rillaboom or the Vileplume if I need to, but that's not the goal of the deck. I think that's really interesting because it really forces you to focus on different threats and kind of prioritize which KOs to take more so than Standard. I felt like I was prize mapping more in GLC than I was when I was playing competitive Standard in Indianapolis. And I think that's really awesome. Something else as well is the format isn't solved, really. There's so many different things you can play that there's not really like a best deck per se. At least maybe not in my opinion. I'm also really new to Gym Leader Challenge, but being able to just kind of have all these different decks out there and these different strategies it's really fun just kind of not knowing how your matchups are going to play out. You know, when I picked up the grass deck, I was like, man, I was like, I hope this is good. I sat down against a water deck and I was like, well, I don't really know how this matchup's going to go. I don't really know what I'm supposed to be doing. So you just kind of have to play it by ear as the game progresses. And that to me was so fun. And I also had to make all different kinds of like odd lines of play, I would say. There was a couple times where I actually tried to like sleep stall with the Fungus, that is the pre-evolution of Amoongus. It has an attack for just one energy where your opponent's active Pokemon is now asleep. There was a couple times where I was like, I don't really know what else to do that makes sense, because I can't really do any damage right now. I was like, I'm going to try to sleep stall my opponent's active. So I just use boss, pull up something they don't want up in the active, and then made it go to sleep and hoped that they didn't end up waking up when they rolled for the status check in between turns. And I think that's really awesome because you don't see that now in standard. It's so fast and it's so aggressive that you don't really have to rely on these like goofy plays that you do in Gym Leader Challenge, or even something that comes to my mind is like a pre-release. There have been tons of times when I was playing in a pre-release where I would be like, okay, you know, try to make it go to sleep and hope that it happens for a turn. And to me, that's really fun. There was not any competitive nature going on when I was playing in Gym Leader Challenge. It was so casual. Everyone was laughing and having fun, trying to just figure out the decks they were playing and laughing around and goofing. And it was just such an awesome experience. And I'm so excited that Gym Leader Challenge is at my locals now, and I'm able to play these at least once a month, maybe even twice a month now. And I'm really excited to start earning badges as well. It's like a really, like, just friendly competition in a league. There's only two badges that have been earned so far at my locals for Gym Leader Challenge, me being the second one, the second badge to get earned in grass, and the first one going to my friend, I believe Andrew Martin, who played Dark. And I think just the fact that, okay, now I have a grass badge, now I get to, like, cook up an entirely different deck. So, like, I'm sitting at work on, like, lunch, and I'm like, man, what deck should I build next? Like, is fire something that'd be really cool? Well, I get to play Magma Basin, so that's a really cool energy accelerator. Okay, well, what else? Oh, I could play, like, Psychic Spread Damage with, like, a Comfey and try to get to, like, 10 in the Lost Zone and play Sableye. Like, how does Dragon types even work? And, like, it's so much fun with this format and all these different strategies you can cook up. And the decks aren't expensive. It's so beginner-friendly and so just, like, entry-friendly. I spent, I think, maybe $30 total on my Grass Gym Leader Challenge deck. And that was only because I really wanted to play with Shiny Genesect, and I also wanted to add that card to my collection. So if I don't play with that Shiny Genesect, my entire deck costs me maybe $20, maybe $25. And that is so cheap to play in the Pokemon trading card game. And I think that's something else that GLC really has going for it, is that it's so just beginner-friendly, and maybe not beginner-friendly, but like entry-friendly. It's not really expensive, but even beginner-friendly, someone who played Magic the Gathering for quite some time, Commander was something that I had played for probably at least half of my Magic career. And it was actually what I started out with at first, because it was a very casual format. Everyone was just there to have fun and just play for fun. And you got to learn all these different cards and stuff. And there wasn't really any sort of competitiveness attached to playing Commander at my locals. And that's exactly how Gym Leader Challenge feels, is there's not any competitive nature really behind it, as I can feel anyway. And that's something that I think also it has going for it, is it's a singleton format, minus those basic energies, of course. And just really being able to kind of hone in on that. And it really forces you to go, okay, well, I can't play four Iono, but what I can do is I can play an Iono, I can play a Judge, I can play a Marnie, and Roxanne. So you have four cards that kind of do the same thing, but have different stipulations to them. So I think that's really interesting. And when I was playing in the tournament, not many times did I look at my opponent's discard pile and count how many Ionos they had, or how many times have you played boss. Like, sure, there's boss, there's Guzma, you can play like Rhyme, you can play, you know, all different kinds of things like that, but I don't have to worry about, okay, well, they've played three Ionos, they're probably playing four, they could probably even Palpad like as well this turn to put two back into the deck. If they play Palpad, they can only put one Iono back in the deck because, well, you can only play one. And I think that's so incredible about Gym Leader Challenge. So that's going to do it for today's video. I'll make sure to keep up with this Gym Leader Challenge stuff. I really enjoyed playing in the tournament, and I really want to try to make maybe some vlogs about Gym Leader Challenge at my locals and really just kind of see where this goes. So if you guys want to join the content I've been making so far here on the channel, don't forget to leave a like, smash that subscribe button. I really would appreciate it. And I'll see you all in the next one. Peace!